Hi, it's Kevin Lebates here, and today I thought I'd talk about hashes and checksums. So I've gone over hashes before in the video, but just to quickly recap, a hash is a method whereby you take a message and you condense it down into a fixed length string. And if it's a cryptographic hash, then the idea is that each message produces a unique hash. So they are meant to be collision proof. You're not meant to be able to find two messages that produce the same hash. Now, technically speaking, it should be possible, but if the space of possible hash outputs is big enough, then the odds of you finding two messages that have colliding hashes is very, very low. Whereas a checksum gives you the possibility of not just determining that the message hasn't been tampered with, but if it has been, you can even have something called error correction, where the checksum allows you to recover the original message. And there's a sort of limit on checksums. If you really wanted to be able to recover the message regardless of how mangled it became, you'd actually need to repeat the message again and ensure that the checksum wasn't damaged in transmission, say through data loss or data corruption. And there are a number of different checksum methods. The easiest one is where you send along a number that says whether the message has an even or an odd number. That's a parity check. And then there are things like Hamming codes, which are a little bit longer, but actually allow you to detect how many bits were damaged and possibly even correct them. So there is a distinction between hashes and checksums, and they do actually serve different purposes. One is checksums are for detecting errors due to data transmission corruption, whereas hashes are to ensure message integrity, that is to make sure that people haven't tampered with the message in the first place. And as a result, checksums are much easier to game or to fake, because you can make a different message. It doesn't take much work to then produce the checksum, and you can just change a few bits here and there in order to get the checksum output that you actually want. Whereas with hashes, because you don't know what the hash output is going to be until you crank the handle and run the function, it's much, much harder, because you have to basically brute force it, and that can involve centuries or millennia of effort, or even the length of the universe if your cryptographic hash is good enough. So that's a quick video on checksums and hashes. Hope you found it interesting. Leave a comment below if you have anything to say, and see you in the next video soon. Bye for now.